Hello everyone, this is Rick with CyberMedics, and we're here today to talk about Zoho's email system. It's primarily oriented towards business users, but thought it would be useful to go through the second factor authentication process for securing this email system. So here we'll walk through the process for you. So after you've set up your account, put in your email address, enter your password, and sign in, we'll select mail. Over here is your profile, and you'll go to my account. On the left side over here, you'll select multi-factor authentication. And the first step we'll go through is to set up the OTP authentication. Today we're going to use the Yubico Authenticator. You could use the Microsoft, you could use Google. I like Yubico because the authentication is actually stored on a security key. So we come up here and we say scan the QR code, which is this thing right over here. Scan QR code, and in this case, for whatever reason, it failed, which is not a bad thing because walking through the manual process is important, and we'll walk you through that now. So we'll hit cancel. We'll come up here and we'll say add an account. We'll type in the issuer, put in the account name, your email address. We'll come over here, we'll copy this code, and it's an important thing to do. Anytime you set up an authenticator app, you should have access to this code, and you should store it electronically in an encrypted file, and ideally on a piece of paper stored in a safe somewhere. So we'll copy that. Now we'll paste that key into the authenticator app, and we'll say add the account. And now you can see this account has been added. So we'll click next here. And it's asking us to enter the TOTP codes that are generated by the authenticator app. So we'll double click this, and the codes are copied to a clipboard. And then we paste those codes in here, and we say verify and continue. Now, the next step is for backup codes. These are critically important because if you lost your access to your second factor authentication, you would want to be able to use these codes to get access to your account. And again, ideally, you should print these out on a piece of paper, store them in a safe, copy them electronically to an encrypted file, make sure that file is accessible via the cloud. So that way you have access to the codes if you ever lost your authentication method. So let's close these down. Now that we've set up the OTP authenticator, we'll come down here and we will set up a YubiKey. So you insert the key in your electronic device and click next. You'll get two prompts and you'll select OK for both of those. You're going to enter the PIN that you previously set up for the key and select OK. You're going to touch the side of your key and then you're going to give it a name. You're going to say configure. And now you can see the YubiKey. It's that simple. I really am impressed with Zoho's simplified process for adding second factor authentication. I think it's one of the most straightforward process for adding it that I've seen. Microsoft account Outlook.com is probably the worst. But I would have to say Zoho is in top tier as far as ease of use for adding second factor authentication. All right, so what we're going to do now is we're going to say make this primary, and it's going to say confirm that you want to make the YubiKey the primary second factor authentication. We'll say confirm, and again, I'm impressed with their process here. If you're making a change, they're definitely assuring that that's something that you want to do and that you validate who you are. So you click here, and you have to enter your password. Because I've linked this password to my Bitwarden account, it's real simple, Control-Shift-L, and it fills automatically. Highly encourage you to watch our Bitwarden password manager account videos. So we'll say confirm password. And now, it still hasn't made it the primary, okay, but now we click one more time, and it's going to ask you confirm it again, and now you see YubiKey is the primary account for second factor authentication. All right, we'll come over here, we'll sign out of the account, put in your email address, password, sign in, enter the key, I mean the PIN for your key, click OK, touch your key, and we'll say not now, and you can see we use the key to get into the account. And we look at our multi-factor authentication, YubiKey is the primary, OTP is the secondary. So we're going to log out of the account, we're going to sign back in again, and this time we're going to select cancel. Let's say we lost our key. Okay, so I want to show you how this process works. So you don't have your key, you say problem signing in. This is really slick the way they've done this. Authenticator app, bring up your app, double click the account, copy it to the clipboard, paste it, and then say verify. We're going to say not now, and bang, you're in. So they've defaulted to your secondary, second factor authentication. So we're going to log out of this again. Next, password, sign in. We're going to say cancel. We're going to say problem signing in. And we're going to say you can't access your mobile device. So the scenario here is basically you've lost your key that you added to the account. You've lost access to your authenticator app. And you're going to say can't access that device. And now you're going to say use the backup verification codes. So first time through, we're just going to mistype the code on purpose and say it's incorrect. Type the code correctly and say verify and say not now. And this is a case where I logged in so many times making this video, it's saying that you have a maximum of 20. That's probably not going to be a problem for most people. Yes, I understand. And there you go. You're logged in. So you had lost your key. You defaulted to your authenticator app. If you lost your authenticator app, your fallback is your backup codes. So in summary, we first set up the authenticator app, and then we set up the YubiKey, and then we went in and generated backup codes. So we had three second factor authentication methods set up on this. Let us know if you have any comments or questions below. Hope you will consider subscribing and have a great hack-free day.